In the last video was explaining about models, let's move to the next input fields. I made this prefix looking things for flux models. Stable diffusion 1.5 model. Then the XL model. To do so, you can just create folders inside the stable diffusion like this. This folder name will be visible before the model's name. If I select flux, there is this extra input fields appears. We should look at it. This is not needed. What are these buttons for? And then this section here. Let's understand this. When switching back to stable diffusion, there is this input field with the title, clip skip, with the maximum value of 12. Clip skip works in the clip network of stable diffusion models. The prompts we type are understood and converted into tokens so the models can produce an image. There are multiple steps involved in the process of understanding the prompt. This step contains details about the subject we mention in the prompt. Every next step has more details than the previous step about the subject. When understanding the prompt, clip skip controls the number of steps to be skipped. Keeping the skip value to 3 means it should skip the last 3 steps and should understand what we are asking for. Changing the preset by selecting XL removes the clip skip option. The reason I can think of is, it is not supported. Selecting the flux preset gives some new input fields. This drop-down, diffusion in low bits, is one of those fields. The name says what it does, diffusing flux model in low bits. If I select a model, a low bit compared to the larger FP16 model, and I let this input value be to automatic. Do note that, this model will work on 3000 and 4000 series card only. It may not work with older cards. Please share in the comments if it works. My prompt will be a flying dog, and I will click generate. I got the image as we normally get using flux. If you saw my previous video about explaining the models, this BNB model is smaller than the original FP16 model. Selecting automatic lets the program decide the bit size for different models. This decision was made based on the model we selected. Let's try adding a LoRa to the model. This retro anime LoRa was trained with the base model of FP16. A larger model. If I click the LoRa, the respective tag will be added into the prompt. Let's generate an image with the LoRa. There is no error in the program's output. Also, the image generated is without the retro anime effect. In this case, the LoRa was trained with a FP16 model. And we are using a smaller quantized model. The LoRa needs to be patched with a lower bit. So it goes along the model and has its effect. If I select automatic for the model, and FP16 in the bracket for the LoRa, I get the LoRa effect on the image generated by the model. This time the system knew to check the bit size, and there is a LoRa in the process. There are multiple, we can choose based on the model. Or it's better to leave it on automatic. Next there is this swap method. Selecting a queue means one task at a time. The next task will wait until the one in progress gets complete. I am not talking about when you generate some image and wait watching the generation progress. What I mean here is the things happening inside the computer, with the graphic card. The async option here allows the program to proceed to the next task, even if a previous task is still in progress. I did not try measuring the performance in both the cases, but async makes things faster on a capable system. Do note, running ahead with a pending task behind also has disadvantages. Next is the swap location. Loading a model occupies space in your dedicated graphic card. In case it's a larger model, selecting swap location as CPU will load the model into your computer's RAM. The other space is the shared graphic memory. If I select shared and hit generate, the large model will utilize the shared space, which is the RAM, accessible to graphic card. Next is the GPU weights. It controls limiting the graphic memory. The swap location example I showed just now, it happened when I limited the graphics from 16 to 12 gigabytes, which made the model going into other spaces available. This section, I think, no explanation needed. You can increase the weight of a specific word by pressing the control and the up arrow key to increase the importance when generating an image. Similarly, when selecting the LoRa, you can adjust the number that represents the weight of the LoRa to control its effect. Let's look at this section. First, this blue button here. For this, let me get an image quickly. Imagine this is the best image an AI can generate. Nothing comes near to this. And for some reason, I refresh the page and everything becomes blank. The blue button has a functionality for bringing back the prompt and other values back from previous generated image. The image will be the same because it brought the seed ID as well. Next, I will have an image which is generated by using an Excel model. And this image is on the top right now. I will copy all the generation data like we do for Comfy UI. Back into Forge, I will paste all the copied data into prompt box. I will press the blue button and all the data in the prompt box went to their input fields. Let's generate. The image is not the way it was, but you got the point. Let me try another one. Copy the data. And then into the positive prompt box. Set all the values and generate. So, it works. The model we have selected matters. Next is this clear prompt. It does what it says. This button applies the style if it is selected in the drop-down below. In the process, it also removed the comment in the prompt. If you type a hash and then some text, it should not have any effect. It's a comment. In both the images there was no rocket. If I remove and keep the hash before the dog, having no subject in the prompt, it may generate anything. But you can have the prompt on a different line, it will work. If it have been a rocket, you can enable or disable this comment in the settings. Back to the styles. There is a lot to choose from. Selecting any style will bring it here. I have selected this too. So, I will click this apply button. The comment I added has been removed. And the prompt from the style is added. This is style. Then this also came from the style. It has quite an impact on the image. And there are so many styles to choose from. This is an option to edit the styles. Styles are text prompts, which are added around the original prompt to have its effect. You can select any one of the styles and make the changes, then save it by clicking Save button. This prompt in the curly bracket. This will be replaced with the original prompt we wrote in the prompt box. You can change the position if you want. The word prompt and the curly brackets was replaced by the original prompt, flying rocket. The remaining text in the style covered the original prompt. There is this refresh button. I think it has no effect, but we can always refresh the page. This apply style button is the same we saw before. This button brings the prompt from back section into this prompt box visible here. In case if we decide to save the new prompt as a style. The generation section I will be covering in the next video. Trying to keep the videos short. Let me know if you learned something.